Hello students, today we start the third unit, that is steam power plant and gas power plant. It carries 14 marks, 7 marks for steam power plant and 7 marks for gas power plant. So first of all we concentrate on the steam power plant. So what is the working principle of this plant? That is it converts the chemical energy of fuel like coal or gas etc. into the mechanical energy, and which can be further converted into the electrical energy by using the electrical generator. So this is called as a steam power plant. So this is the block diagram of working principle of steam power plant. So how it is works? So it shows some components, major components like boiler, turbine and a generator, which works on the principle of electromagnetic induction. So here the feed water comes into the boiler. Here air fuel mixture is there and flue gases leaves from this side. So here the water comes inside the boiler tubes and it get converted into the steam, that is superheated steam. Then this steam comes into the turbine and impacted on the turbine blades and start to rotate, and the shaft of the generator is coupled to the shaft of the turbine. So here the chemical energy of fuel is converted into the mechanical energy, and now the mechanical energy is converted into the electrical energy here in generator, and finally we get the electricity which forwarded to the power grid. But in during this process some steam goes to the condenser. And then that steam is condensed in the condenser, and then it is again we can reuse that condensed water by sending that water into the boiler. So this is the simple working principle of the steam power plant. Okay, so now we discuss on the actual layout of modern steam power plant. So it consists of four circuits. That is, first one is a coal and ash circuit, second one is a air and gas circuit, and third one is feed water and steam circuit, and the last one is a cooling water circuit. So steam power plant, or you may say that it is a thermal power plant, modern thermal power plant, it is categorized or divided into four circuits, that is coal and ash, then air and gas, then feed water and steam, and finally is a cooling water circuit. So now we just concentrate on the schematic representation of the, or the layout of the steam power plant. Okay, so now we continue with the layout of the steam power plant, and it is divided into the four circuit. That is, first one is a coal and ash circuit. This is a coal and ash circuit actually. Then secondary is a air and gas circuit. So from here preheater, so this is air and gas circuit, second one. Then third one is a feed water and steam circuit. So this one is a feed water and steam circuit, and the last one is a cooling water circuit. So from here this is a cooling tower, so this is a cooling water circuit, this one. So in this way it is categorized into the four circuits, steam power plant, or you may say that this is a modern thermal power plant. So from here there are coal mines, and from coal mines the coal comes into the coal storage, and then it forwarded to the coal handling plant, and then from coal handling plant it comes into the boiler, into the combustion chamber of the boiler. So on the same time the preheated air comes from the preheater. From here it is coming from the preheater, that is the preheated air, which heated by means of with the help of the flue gases. The flue gases which leaves the boiler are goes into this way into the super heater, and then it goes to the economizer, flows from economizer to the again the air preheater, where it preheat the air, which is air coming from the atmosphere, and then that the preheated air is sending again towards the combustion chamber of the boiler for the burning purpose of the coal. So initially when the coal is comes into the boiler, that is combustion chamber, and with the help of preheated air, the feed water is comes from the economizer, and then heated or the hot feed water is collected here, and then at high temperature and high pressure it is converted into the steam, and then that steam is forwarded to the superheater. The flue gases are flows from in this way, so it is already the steam becomes superheated here, and then that steam goes or forwarded to the turbine, and the turbine is coupled to the generator. The shaft of the turbine is coupled to the shaft of the generator. So and finally, when steam impacted on the blades of the turbine, it start to rotate. Blades start to rotate, and the blades are mounted on the shaft of the turbine, and that shaft is coupled to the generator. So the rotary motion here, the mechanical energy is converted into the electrical energy here on the principle of electromagnetic induction, and finally we get the electricity here, which forwarded to the power grid. So here we get the electricity. But when the steam is comes into the superheater, some steam is leaves the turbine and goes to into the condenser. So here some steam is collected in a condenser, where the steam is condensed and it get converted into the water. So means what, phase changing is done here, that is steam to the water. So but when the steam is collected here and condensed, so the when steam leaving the steam turbine in and condensed here in condenser at a low pressure, means what, even below the atmospheric pressure. So using a cooling medium such as cooling tower, it maintain the pressure, or you may say that the cold water supply to the condenser also helps to maintain the low pressure in the condenser, and the same water is then ascending towards the low pressure heater, where the low pressure heater, and here there are the two heaters, low pressure heater and the high pressure heater. This is a feed pump. So the low pressure heater is used to increase the temperature of the water. So it is used to increase the temperature of the water which is coming from the condenser with the help of the extraction pump, that is condensate extraction pump. The water which is coming from the condenser is comes into the low pressure heater, which is used to increase the temperature of water and forwarding to the high pressure heater. The working of the high pressure heater is also same, means what, it again increase the temperature of feed water, and then that heated feed water is forwarded to the economizer. This is economizer, and here with the help of flue gases, here again that water is heated, and that heated water is sending to the boiler, that is hot feed water is sending to the boiler. So because of due to this, when it reaches into the boiler or boiler tubes, it increases automatically the efficiency of the plant or the boiler. So in this way it increases the efficiency. Now whatever the steam is condensed here because of due to the condenser, and here for maintaining the low pressure we using the cooling tower, and here that cooling tower takes the water from the river, and then that cold water becomes hot here because of due to the temperature or the heat exchange from the steam, and it again recirculated here from cooling tower to the condenser. And finally, the whatever the ash is remain here is forwarded to the ash handling plant, and then next proceed to the ash storage. So in this way the steam power plant or a modern thermal power plant is works on the under four circuits, that is coal and ash circuit, air and gas circuit, then feed water and steam circuit, and then the cooling water circuit. I again repeat the working of the steam power plant. So at very first, the coal is coming from the mines and collected here coal storage, then forwarded to the coal handling system, that is coal handling plant. Then it goes from the pulverizer and etc., and then sending to the boiler. At the same time, the preheated air which is coming from the atmosphere is heated here, preheated here, and then sending to the boiler. And then the water which is coming from the economizer, this is economizer, that is heated feed water, hot feed water is collected here and in the boiler tubes, and then the water is converted into the steam, and then that steam is forwarding to the superheater. Again it is superheated here from saturated state to the superheated state, and then it is proceed to the turbine. On turbine, it impacted on the turbine blades, then due to that it rotated the shaft of the turbine, and the shaft of the turbine is coupled to the generator, and then here the electricity is generated which is sending to the application. But on the same time, some heat, some steam is goes to the condenser, where it's condensed, its phase is changed from steam to water, and here the hot water is there but at a low pressure. So for maintaining low pressure, we use here the cooling tower which is recirculated here, and then that water is extracted from the condensate extraction pump and then forwarding to the low pressure heater, where it increases the temperature of the water. Then with the help of feed pump, it is forwarded to the high pressure heater, that is also increased, which is also used to increase the temperature of the water, and then it is heated water is forward to the feed water, forward to the economizer, where with the help of flue gases, heat is exchanged here, and again that heated water is forwarded to the boiler. So, and finally, whatever the ash is remaining, that is sending to the ash handling plant, and from ash handling plant to the ash storage. In this way, the steam power plant works. So this is the working of the steam power plant. Now the advantage of the steam power plants. In the steam power plant, we can use the cheaper fuel as compared to the others. Less space is required as compared to the hydropower plant. It is cheaper in production cost as compared to the other plants. And the disadvantages of the steam power plants are like, its operating cost is very high, its maintenance cost is also very high, and the cost of the plant increases with the increase in the temperature and the pressure. Also, a large quantity of water is required in the cooling tower, that's why these are 3 to 4 are some disadvantages of the steam power plant. So this is all about the steam power plant.